Welcome back to Drumard Farm, our Fendt farm, for episode 7. It's an overcast, foggy morning. We sped up time overnight, simply to clear the night cycle back into daytime. We've got a tractor still up here at the sheep pen. So first things first, we'll see if we need to clear up the sheep again. Yeah, it's a little bit of grass there, so we'll pick that up. It's been a couple of days since I played on this map, so I'm trying to remember what my original plan of action for this episode was going to be. I think we're going to have some fertilizing to do, and probably a little bit more mowing. In there. And switching. Yeah, we had the mower set up there. So that was it. We mowed field 32. Gonna have to clean up after the pigs. Let's put a shovel on this one as well. There's not much mess for the pigs here, actually. It's a bit of a surprise. Pigs cleaned up. It's a bit tight. That camera angle keeps showing me through the wall. Let's leave the bucket on here. There we go. Because we're going to need this for fertilizing our fields. So let's just take a look at our map. Check our growth chart. Yeah, no change to the field states yet. No need to fertilize anything. So let's do a little bit of mowing. And what we're going to do is we're going to run at 5x speed. Just to speed things up a little bit in terms of time progression, get us closer to that next fertilization stage. Just drop our rear mower down. Actually, for the first pass, cruise control set really low. There we go. Just going to stay outside of the cab for the first pass so I can put that border in. actually get to learn the shape of this field. And then once we've done this first border, we'll cut to some in-cab mowing action. I think this field is actually going to be, given its shape, it looks reasonably square. And it's not a massive field. I think this is a perfect candidate for turning into a, a workable grass field rather than leaving it in its natural state like this. So what I might well do is come in with a plough and rip this field up, and then replant it with grass so that we can actually have a field quite close to our farm, which we can massively increase the yield of how much grass we'll get from it in terms of, you know, for hay, for silage. I just think this might be a really good candidate for that. So, some news. I posted this on my Facebook page, and I've picked up a copy of No Man's Sky. It's a game I have been very curious about. Yeah, you know, I was intrigued by it, you know, when it was being hyped up pre-launch. It was one of those games that had a certain, I don't know, about it. And there was something that made me want to try it. I was also very wary of the fact that it might be a game that I wouldn't enjoy or wouldn't live up to the obscene amount of hype that it was getting. I mean, which is essentially exactly what happened. I mean, when the game was launched, it turned out that Hello Games had misled quite a few people, and Sean Murray in multiple interviews had outright lied about some of the game's features. So it certainly failed to live up to the hype, but it was one of those games that just seemed to capture everyone's imagination, you know, during the launch build up. And Sony pushed this thing to the moon. They really hyped it up with their own internal marketing, you know, and external marketing. They saw it as a potential system seller, you know, so they pushed the hell out of this game, you know, when it was launched. And it wasn't what everyone thought it was going to be. It was severely lacking in features, and very underwhelming for a lot of players. So much so that Hello Games' reputation has been so badly tarnished, I don't know if they'll ever recover. I mean, I think what they've done in terms of going in and adding additional features and content into No Man's Sky for free had to be done. You know, it wasn't a case of, you know, we feel we need to do this. You know, it's like, we have no choice, we have to do this. You know, we've messed up on such a scale, you know, that we have no choice, we have to do this, you know, to try and make it right. And even through all of that, and the stream of negative reviews that came out, and criticisms, and, you know, the constant rants about how Hello Games had lied, and how Sean Murray had lied, and despite all of that, there are still people who enjoy the game, and On top of that, there are people who are still curious about playing the game. People still are picking it up and buying it. But they're buying it secondhand most for the most part. You know, if they're buying a disc copy, or they're trying to pick it up on a sale, if they're buying a digital copy. Which is exactly what I've done. I've been watching the game pop up on sale a few times since it was launched on the PlayStation Network, and I've ummed and ahed and thought about it on a number of occasions, and I've always come close to buying it and trying it out. Right, where do we want to go? Which field do we want to try next? Field 34. So yeah, I've ummed and ahed about it on a number of occasions and given it serious thought, but just never quite been close enough to actually go, you know what, yes, I'm gonna buy it. You know, the price has always been a little bit too high. You know, the timing just hasn't been right in that respect, and I haven't felt that it would be worth it. How do I get into field 34? Can I get in? Ah, there's the gate there. But the price is, it's on sale at the moment on the PlayStation Store, will be until the 22nd of March. And the price is the lowest I've ever seen it. It's $13.99. And the cheapest I've seen it before, before today, I picked it up, was about 20 quid. And that was still just a little bit too steep for me. So I thought about it, even seeing it at discounted down to £14. I thought about it and I thought about it and still had to and ah a little bit, but decided I was probably gonna pick it up and give it a go. And yesterday that's exactly what I did. I downloaded the game off the network. And it is now installed on my PS4. I haven't tried it yet. I'm going to probably get a few more episodes of Fendt Farm under my belt, maybe start a second farm on the channel. And I'm also going to be speaking to a couple of buddies of mine about maybe starting my Ghost Recon series as well. There'll be no commentary like this. It'll just be footage of us playing and talking in TeamSpeak. Maybe a couple of little snippets of conversation thrown in afterwards in the editing process. We'll see. But No Man's Sky will be coming to the channel. I don't know how long it'll stay on the channel. Depends how I enjoy the game. I'll be playing it with a view to trying to get the platinum trophy. But if it's out to be similar, then I may curtail any plans for a long recording. This is a very odd-shaped field. Where is the gate? There we go. So yeah, we will be getting some No Man's Sky footage coming up at some point in the near future. Just don't know how long that game will stay on the channel. Yeah, if the episodes feel too samey, and I don't feel that there's any real variety, then I may well, just knock it on the head, just play off. We'll see how that goes nearer the time. One of my viewers has suggested to me that I get rid of the Silo King feeding wagon and replace it with the Keenan feeding wagon, as that's an Irish product. I think I actually discussed this in one of the earlier videos in the series. You know, I was concerned about. I'm still thinking about it. It's a little bit more expensive, has a smaller capacity. And I may have to rework, you know, my to making silage, no, not silage, making total mixed ration. Because it's not a straight 30-30. So I would have to probably scoop in loose straw, and loose silage, and putting it in bale, and put with loose. I haven't used that, so that in itself is a good reason to give it a try, because I haven't used it. It'd be something new. And that, and the fact that you know, it's an Irish piece of machinery, and we're on an Irish farm, would be another good reason. So we will see. I will continue to ponder that one. And we've got plenty of time. I mean, I'm not going to be starting cows within the next episode or two. I've still got plenty of time to just, you know, mull it over a little bit longer before I make my final decision. As things stand at the moment, I am leaning towards doing it and actually getting rid of the Silo King and using the Keenan. Like I said, make a final decision as we get to actually having cows on the farm, which is still a few episodes off yet. We may save cows for episode 10. We'll see how things. I would like to have. I'm assuming that by episode 10 we'll have our first cycle of growth. So, got those beans. We've also got the wheat that we planted on field 2, our brand new field. So I'd like to get that harvest done, dusted, and out of the way before I look at cows, because we're going to need the straw. That's a given. And we're going to need a bit of money to actually buy the cows. So we're going to need to sell those soybeans. This is a very oddly shaped field. It was quite like this. It's going to make it interesting when I try and figure out how I'm going to wrap this up, what path I want to take. Trying to think what else to talk about. I'm a little bit groggy. I've not been up to for too long, so I'm still a little bit tired from not having got a huge amount of sleep. I've got a bad mattress. It's starting to fall apart, unfortunately, and it's getting really uncomfortable. so I don't get a particularly good night's sleep on it. I tend to wake up with a bad back. I've contacted the letting agency on a number of occasions regarding this now, and they're supposed to be, you know, advising the landlord that I need a new mattress. But I'm not holding my breath on that happening anytime soon. Let's just say I haven't been particularly impressed with my letting agency of late. I had to join a buddy of mine for some multiplayer on his farm earlier today before I went to bed. I do say earlier today because even though I'm in the UK, I tend to keep to an American time. Most of the people I talk to, I tend to get. Up until, you know, early, very early hours of the following morning. But yesterday, this morning, I didn't go to bed when I normally do. I just wasn't feeling tired. Excuse me. And a buddy of mine asked for some help on his farm, so I ended up spending about 3 hours helping him out on his farm. And didn't go to bed till around 1 o'clock this afternoon. So I've got about 6 hours of broken sleep, and now I'm back up and recording. I haven't had a lot of feedback on the channel just yet. I've only had a couple of people who've actually commented, but you know, the general feedback that I have received so far does seem reasonably positive. So I thank you for that. For those that have watched and have enjoyed the content, you know, I appreciate. I appreciate that feedback. For anyone who hasn't, you know, left any feedback yet, you know, please do so. You know, I'd love to hear from you. You know, let me know in my down below area. You know, drop some comments, or, you know, if you're on Facebook, you know, you can click the banner on the Facebook link on the banner of my YouTube page. Go to my Facebook page, you can send me a message on there. You can comment on any of the posts that I make. You know, I do announce each episode being live on the website, being live on the channel on the Facebook page as well, and I do post other stuff on there as well. That was my big announcement yesterday or early this morning about why I decided to go for No Man's Sky. So you can reach me there as well. There is a direct message button option if you wanted to send me a message, or, as I say, you can comment on one of my posts and reach me that way. I really want to hear from you guys, you know, because your feedback lets me know whether I'm doing a good job or not. So I'd love to hear from you. Alright, let's park this guy up just here for now. So I might go and do one more field. And this Fendt needs to go back. But before we do take him back, we're going to use him to row. And then use the forage wagon to collect and dump at the silage pit. Put a little bit more silage in there, or a little bit more chaff in there. Let's get the easier field out of the way first. Through the gap, let's unfold. I'm not going to hit the gate. Possibly. Definitely. There we go. Lower. Back up a little bit. There we go. Turn on. And we're off. And rowing we will go. So for all you Marvel fans out there, Iron Fist is now available on Netflix. I sat down and watched that, let's see, it's Sunday today, I watched that Friday night through into Saturday morning, and watched it in two halves. I watched like the first six or seven episodes, and then took a break, did some recording, which you know you've now seen. And then once I'd finished doing some recording and I wanted to process a couple of episodes and upload them, you know, I then watched the rest of the season of Iron Fist. I have to say I enjoyed it. I think it's probably the weakest of the four Defender series so far in terms of their individual series. That's just my personal preference. You know, I love the Daredevil stuff. They did that so well. The way they did, you know, the origin story of Daredevil over the first season, and then the way they brought in and dealt with the Punisher and Elektra, and they gave the Punisher the Daredevil treatment that they'd given, you know, him in season one. By really doing a fantastic origin story of the Punisher throughout season two, that was brilliant. It's just really dark, gritty, enjoyable television. Luke Cage was good. I enjoyed Luke Cage. I really enjoyed Jessica Jones, but that's probably more because I am a massive fan of David Tennant. And he was just amazing in his role. Such a great actor, you know, and you know, he can really turn on the menace when he wants to. And then I'll see Iron Fist, you know, coming out on the 17th. I think, like I said, as a season, I think it was the weakest of the four, in my own personal opinion. But that's not to say it was bad. It was good. You know, it's just if I were to rank the four Defenders as they are right now, I would put, you know, Daredevil top, Jessica Jones second, Luke Cage third, and Iron Fist fourth in terms of how much I enjoyed, each show. But I'm pumped now, really pumped for Defenders coming out this year. I think it's September, October time when they're going to do that crossover and actually do the Defenders. So I'm really, re ooh, excuse me, really looking forward to that now. Now that we've got all four characters out there. We know that we've got a third season of Daredevil in the planning. We know that there's a second season of Jessica Jones that's being filmed this year. As far as I know, there's going to be a second season of Luke Cage next year, maybe. I think we're looking at next year at the very earliest before we see a new season of Daredevil. See where I'm going. There we go. I was just about to put this away and I just remembered we've got another field that we need to row. There it is. But yeah, I enjoyed, as I said, I enjoyed Iron Fist. It started well, a little slowly, I think. But the characters that it introduced, I think it introduced them well. Colleen Wing was a great character at the start. I felt maybe she got a little bit washed out a little bit. She became less of a badass and more of a lovesick sidekick kind of thing as the series went on. But definitely a great supporting character. The nurse Claire popped up, of course. She's been in every single one of the season, the characters' seasons at the moment. She's obviously going to be the integral link that pulls all four of them together at the start of Defenders, because she's the one who knows all of them. And Jessica Jones and Luke Cage have already had their own crossover in Jessica Jones before Luke Cage got his own series. And Daredevil is referred to in, I think, all the other guys' seasons, with the exception possibly of Jessica Jones. But I think Daredevil is mentioned in Jessica Jones as well. So it seems to me that Claire is the plot device. Now that she's been in all four characters' shows, she is going to be the plot device that unites the four of them, brings them all together. Now, whether that's through an introduction or whether it's, the four of them coming together, to avenge a brutal murder of Claire, who knows? But if Claire gets brutally murdered and they all converge to join forces to track her, track down her killer. You heard it here first. But yeah, she's obviously going to be the one that that ties them all together, because she's the only one that knows all four of them. We had J Money in there as well, again, Hogarth, the lawyer. We saw her briefly. She was in and out of Jessica Jones. I think we saw her briefly in Luke Cage, very, very briefly. We definitely saw her briefly at the very end of Daredevil, when Foggy goes his own way. But those have always been very, very short guest, guest spots, just like popping up at the very end kind of thing, as a maybe a segue into a new season. Oh, I missed a patch of grass, look. Completely did not realize I'd done that. Let's get this field finished off. How are we doing for time? We've got about 15 minutes left, maybe a little touch less. I did forget to start my timer straight away again. But I'm putting that down to sleep more than anything else, because I did actually have it all, even started or set the timer and prep there, ready, started the recording. And it was a little bit fun. We'll get a decent amount of grass here off these fields. What am I, forage wagon will be able to make that turn. It might be a little bit too tight. Yeah, a decent amount of grass from these fields. Nothing amazing, you can see that the rows that I'm leaving aren't, bulging at the seams. But they're a decent size. Big enough to build us a lot. I don't, if we look at the price of silage. Oh, wow, look at the price of wool. Some of the pricing on this map does seem a bit off. I mean, the price of wool, that's pretty high, but the price of silage there, over 1,000 per 1,000 liters, that's very, very high. That's the highest I've seen. So I was playing some old streams, last night / this morning, after I'd finished getting my my last couple of videos uploaded, I decided to take a break and play a little bit of old streams, because it's been a little while since I've been on that map. And the price of silage on there per 1,000 liters is around 230, and when we started this farm, it was around 1,200 and something, so over £1,000 per 1,000 liters more. And I think the silage might potentially be a game breaker on this map. I think the silage might be a little too high. A little bit too much money to be made that way. We'll find out for definite once we actually get our silage operation up and running. But it does concern me that you can make that much money with silage on this map. I have to confess, it does give me cause for thought, or pause for thought. Because if it does turn out to be that much of a money maker, it probably means I won't be doing any silage again on this map. Because it's the fields aren't that expensive. We've got most of the equipment that we're going to need. I said most, there is still some that I want to get. I just don't think we're ever gonna need to make, you know, a million or so off of silage. I want to explore logging on this map, and I want to get into root crops, you know, potatoes and sugar beets, and that there in itself, you're talking all the equipment needed for those three things there, plus the buildings and storage that will be going down to accommodate those as well. You're talking 1.5 million easy in terms of the equipment, in terms of a Scorpion King, in terms of a Terrados from Holmer, in terms of a potato harvester from a company whose name I can't remember. I can't remember who makes the potato harvester now. But all of that equipment added up, you're talking at least, you know, combined with the need to put in some storage sheds for certain things, and we'll also need trailers, and we may well need a truck cab. We'll need a wood chipper and all this and that. You're talking 1.5 million in cost, easy, to get all of those things set up. We don't need to do them all in one go. That's pretty obvious, but we certainly don't have the money to do them all in one go, and I want to keep expanding the field selection that we have as well. So it's definitely going to be something that'll be done in stages. But beets will be the next thing that we push towards. We have a field that's already set up. It's pretty much perfect for beets. And that's the grass field that we've got growing on 33, until we're in a position to turn that into a beet farm, a beet field. We've got that large area next to the field that's flat and undeveloped, that's perfect for turning it into a storage area for beets and potatoes. Just pull this forward a little bit. There we go. And then we also have. Oh, I need the forage wagon, don't I? Yeah, we have those mods that I want to try out, those storage mods, which can hold up to 300,000 litres of root crops. And we need the sugar beets for our pigs, you know, so we can get away from being reliant on pig pallets when it comes to the food. We are going to need root crops for that, so what am I catching up? There's nothing there. Look. Oh, I'm catching on. Oh, now I'm completely stuck. Little glitches like that really wind me up sometimes. Once you learn where they are and what they are, you know, you can adjust your playing style to accommodate them. Just have to be wary and just make sure you remember about them. I don't think I'll be ploughing this field. It's such a weird shape. That I don't know if I'll do a lot of work on this field. Because I'm thinking ahead to being able to use the merger. And this field would not be merger friendly. To the final sort of 5 minutes or so of the episode, so we can probably get a couple more runs around the field before we have to call it an episode. Yeah, but if this field was ploughed and was properly fertilized, this trailer would already have been full. Oh, struggling to get up this hill. Come on, you can make it. No, I was talking about maybe doing some, trying to get into beets next. It's going to be expensive to do that because we're going to need several hundred thousand for the, even for the smaller of the two Holmer Pterodos harvesters. We're going to need around 400,000 for that. You know, for that plus the header. So we may go logging first. You know, we may just lease a Scorpion. Lease a Scorpion King and then just cut down a whole load of trees and then process them afterwards, once we've returned the Scorpion King. If we lease it and return it for, run it for 2 hours and just cut down as many trees in 2 hours as we can, that would work, I think. Okay, so I need to set cruise control. Set it for 2. And start dumping and start driving. Trying to get a nice even tip. That's not bad. Could have gone a little bit faster. So we'll do one more trip around the field. Where do we stop? Just up here. Turn the light so that it's brightened up a little bit. That was tight. Next one's going to be even tighter. I don't know if we'll be able to make it or not. Yeah, we are fast approaching the end now. So I want to thank everyone for watching, and for those of you that have commented and reached out to me on Facebook as well, thank you for your feedback, much appreciated. Please do continue to do so. I'd love to be able to strike up a regular conversation with some of you guys in the comments. I'd love to read out some of your questions in future videos. So do please, let me know in the down below. Make sure you subscribe to the channel to keep up to date with videos as they are released. You can also go to my Facebook page, Jim Bob Plays Games, all separate words. And keep up to date with my plans for the channel and when content is released, and what I'm thinking about doing next, and other random musings will pop up on there as well. So please do take the time to just pop over there and drop a like on that page, so that you can get that get those stories popping into your news feed. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope you'll stick around and continue to watch the series as it progresses. As we finish off this trailer, nothing remains now except to say thank you for watching, and I will catch you back on the farm next time.